Hey guys, Karzie here. A sick Karzie at that. And, well, I felt like, we need to talk. I haven't talked to you guys with one of these videos in a while, and, you know, these are mainly, you know, so you guys have a knowledge of, make sure what's going on with the channel and my life, but the other half of the reasoning is kind of for me. I'm one of those really weird people that I guess it's not that weird actually, but I'm one of those people that when I talk to people or friends about problems I have, it helps me think about it a lot. It helps me accept it better, or it's therapeutic for me, I guess is the best way to put it. Like, I'm very, very stuck on problems on my own, so when I incorporate other people, it helps me think, even if they don't do anything, just thinking they're there reading what I'm typing or listening to what I'm saying usually helps me out a lot. So this is half for that too. I wanted to talk about a lot. This season, this past year, a little bit plans for the future. You know what? What's kind of going on behind the scenes? Because let's face it, this past year I've barely done anything. I've gotten what was it? Dungeons and Dragons and suits. I've barely done anything else, and you know that's a lot on me. I'm not gonna lie. But I feel like there are reasons why, and maybe I'm having a hard time accepting them myself, or maybe I'm just taking too long to get over them. So, you know what, I'm kind of doing this a little bit as a shot in the dark to help everyone, or help me, fuck. Like I said, one of those people, if I think people are listening, it usually helps. So this past year has been really, really slow on the channel. You know, we broke 300. Yeah, that's a good number. I think there seems to be a lot more people coming and going on average. So it's been more active, which is always nice. It's always great to feel that. I guess one of the, you know, this past year has been kind of rough. A lot of things in life, namely dealing with financials, is that a word, financials, have been a little rough. This year was supposed to be kind of a year of luck, in a sense, but nothing ever came through, so, God, it's, I know that's weird to hear. You're probably wondering, like, what the fuck are you talking about? I can't say bad investments because it's not really bad. Let's just say plans fall through, and you know, that's not exactly, you know, the main reason why or anything like that. But I just want to elaborate. This past year has been kind of rough. There's been a lot of emotions going on. There's been a lot of financial problems, a lot of personal issues among people I know. Not so much me personally. This past year has been back and forth for me personally. You know, life at home sometimes gets hard. You know, I'm living happily with my fiance, and this is the first, you know, woman I've ever lived with or loved for, been with for this long. So, you know, I'm still kind of learning how to be, you know, the whole husband, pre-husband thing. I don't know what you classify it as, but let's just say I'm not experienced in the whole living with women thing. And the past few years have been enlightening, but, you know, there's relationship issues. Well, not issues. God, I didn't mean to say it like that. Now everyone thinks it's horrible. There's, you know, things you learn, over time, you know, little things that add up, that get frustrating, you get off your chest, and you know, in relationships, the other party doesn't always perceive it well, or it's not expressed well. You know, these are things I'm still learning, and I know they have affected me. Now you're probably wondering, what the fuck does this have to do with the channel? I'm just kind of painting a broad picture of just things that are coming to mind over the past year, leading up to, well, I guess one of the main things I wanted to point out was, about the beginning of this year, 2016, I had to go to court. Now, I don't really want to talk why. It's not a big thing. Nothing horribly big happened, so don't worry. It's not like a huge issue. But while I was there, now keep in mind, you may see me in a different light, but outside my walls, I am a fairly anxiety fearful person. I don't like to go out. Don't get me wrong, I like parties, but I have to be dragged to them by my friends. They have to be really specific good situations. But for anything important, for any, what's a word for it? Just stuff like going to court. I don't know, just... Fuck, even going to the haircut sometimes makes, you know, on a bad day, I have a lot of anxiety going there. You know, I just don't like to always be around a lot of people. It's just always been a tick of mine. I don't really trust a lot of people that often. God, I even hate going to Walmart when it's busy. Oh, God, Christmas Walmart. Horrible. Horrible. I love going there at, like, 11 o'clock at night, though. It's just vastly weird people and no one wants to do anything with anybody. It's great. Either way. So, this court thing. I bring this up because it was a very strange experience for me. It's the first time I've ever been to court. It was even like in like a little tiny room. It was weird. The judge in particular, I guess he didn't know what YouTube is or was, and I kind of had to define what I do, like, what's my only form of income. YouTube's my only form of income, and I'll be honest, there's no income, so there's nothing to show for this channel. I've maybe gotten... what, $100 over the past 4 years, maybe, I think, and even then, like, that's not much. I mean, people can make that in like a day easily, usually. I'm not bitching about that. You know, I love making videos, but it's hard to have something to show for it when the rest of the world is looking in. When my parents are, you know, asking what I do, and I don't have anything to show for it, you know. Mostly my dad's side of the family is very, very, you are what business you are, and that's what defines you as a person. And so you know, what you do in a, you know, to make a living is kind of a big deal, and it brings me a lot of shame to talk about with them, because I know they don't get it. They don't understand anxiety and shit like that. They don't understand some of the shit I went through, which, you know, that's a different story, and that's not for here. That's not what I was meant to. Wow, I've gotten off track. Holy fuck. Okay, back to the case in point, the court thing. So I basically had to tell a judge what I do. Meanwhile, you know, he doesn't believe that I make next to nothing. Meanwhile, I also have to show this judge that my anxiety is very real. And to try to explain all these things with YouTube being this huge focus is really hard. Think about it. I'm trying to explain to this person who thinks I'm like just conning him, making dollar bills, y'all, behind his back or some shit. And I'm trying to tell him I make these YouTube recording videos and I have anxiety and I make next to nothing. And, you know, you think this would be easy. You think this would be something that would be like, oh, okay, you know, we'll spend maybe two, three minutes on that, and or 5 minutes tops, and we'll move on to the next, you know, criteria. No, this judge was, I don't know, maybe he thought I was like, I starred on MTV Cribs or some shit, because he was asking all these fucking YouTube questions, exactly what I do, down to details, and, oh god, it was so defeating, and it's not like, it's like I say, it's not the fact that, you know, I'm ashamed of, I don't have a whole lot to show from working on this channel so much. You know, I'm kind of okay with it. I like making videos. People come and go. You know, I've made a few friends. This has been a pretty good experience for me, and I like to keep it going. But when it comes to the rest of the world and how money reliant it is and how I'm always seem to be dealing with old people that don't understand a lot of new age things, it's very difficult because there is so much shame and guilt and judgment there. And that's a lot of what I get from my dad's family. And, you know, a lot of it's in my head. I won't lie. A bit of it is in my head. But I still know them. I still know them too well. And I just got a huge, unexpected, overflooding amount of this emotion from this judge. And it fucked me up. I said for the longest time, it fucked with my chi, because that's the closest thing I could think about it. The urge to record, create, have fun, and just edit and spend time and doing this and talking to people, you know, it fucked up my chi. I didn't have a whole lot of, you know, everything became, I have nothing to show for it, so almost continuing it was almost shameful to my family's eyes, which, like I say, doesn't affect me personally alone, but the fact that it affects other people affects me. That's what I'm trying to get at here. Now, I'm not trying to, you know, make this huge depressing, you know, oh, poor you type of thing. I'm just, again, this, a bit of this is for me. It's just to get it off my chest. And fuck, you know, I'm tired of this being an issue. And maybe if I express it, maybe it won't be. Maybe this is, I'm hoping this is one of those things that, you know, how to say it, when you bring it to the light, it's not scary anymore type of thing. I'm kind of hoping that that's what's going to happen, because I am so tired of thinking about this fucking judge. God, I can't even remember what I ate yesterday, let alone maybe when I woke up. But this judge, I remember. And oh my god, it was partly traumatizing. But so it fucked with my chi a lot. And I understand that affected me. I didn't have a lot of urge to do anything. I just kind of wanted to rejuvenate my spirit, get my chi back together, and come back strong. Luckily, around this time is when my friends really wanted to do Dungeons and Dragons, and that was perfect. It was such a perfect middle ground. It was an easy way for me to get back into things. It was a fun experience with friends. It was something new. I really enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun with it. And I wanted to bring it to YouTube. I wanted to use that as my content, because I also knew, you know, like I said, I haven't been making a whole lot of content lately, and whenever I get an urge to do something, I would love to make content. And at the same time, if for some reason I'm old and gray and I forget like everything for some reason, and YouTube for some reason is still around, I kind of would like, you know, something to reflect on. You know, this is the closest, I don't really keep pictures. This is the closest thing I have to like a photo album is a video album. Either way, so that happened, and I really enjoyed it. Even though, man, it was an easy ride for me. You know, I was the newbie. I don't know D&D. I was just there along for the ride and just trying to understand what everything was. And I liked it. I did have a lot of fun. And I hope to do it again sometime. I imagine people liked it. I've heard nothing but good things about that. But holy fuck, have I gotten severely off track. How long is this now? Holy shit. Well, this video is going to be like a lot longer than I thought it would be. I haven't even gone through everything I want to talk about. I just felt like I should ramble that. So, I think I painted a picture, you know. But, okay, one last little piece of the picture. After the whole D&D thing, I got a lot of new equipment. I got, you know, this sound wall, got a better microphone. I got a lot of fancy shit. I'm really excited to use it and was happy about it. So I made suits, and I had a lot of fun with that. But, you know, basically this past year has been not a whole lot of action from me. And I understand that, but I hope you understand that the world has had fucked with my chi, and I probably have to go back to court sometime in the next few months, and hopefully I'll never ever ever have to do that again, and hopefully YouTube won't be the focus. And I think that's what I kind of forgot to mention earlier, is this whole process wasn't supposed to be about YouTube. It's just, that's what happened. This judge was just, that's all he wanted to talk about for like the entire time I was there. And it was so weird. Like, I was not expecting this at all. But, oh God, it was such a huge focus. And I'm just, like I say, I'm just trying to paint a picture. This past year has been chi fuckery, but you know, there's
good in the future. There's hope. I'm still here. I still want to work at it. And yeah.
You know.
So.
After painting that picture, hopefully that explains a little bit why this channel has been very, very empty this past year. Not to mention, I've been sick as fuck. It seems like ever since I got this microphone, I've been sick or dealing with drama of some kind. Chi fucking drama. Like, personal shit. Like, God, I didn't really want to mention this, but I'm gonna say personal shit on the level of my mom's boyfriend might be hitting my mom, and she stays away. I ain't cool with that. I'm not gonna say anything because people will think the wrong things and take it too far. But I want it not to ever happen ever again. So, you know, it's shit like that that has been affecting my mind lately, and I know it suffered through the channel. But that's not every day all day. There, you know, I still want to do stuff. I still definitely have urge to play and hang out and do stupid shit. I mean, I love this. It's fun for me. I like it. I can just pick apart games and just be like, oh, look at that picture. It looks like a dumb elephant car. You know, I like that. This is also saying that even though saying all this, I don't really expect to make a whole lot of videos this next month or so. Last year I made a video, probably the last time I made a To My People video. Say Christmas is always, around this season in general, November, December, January, it's always hard for me because a lot of depressing memories have happened. My grandma passed away, my brother passed away, my dad killed my bird on Christmas. Yeah, there's a lot of things that fuck with me, and when I am alone, I tend to dwell on a lot of these things. So trying to, you know, prepare myself for recording, you know, I gotta like set up a sound wall, clean my desk a little, like glass and shit, you know, I gotta do a little. I'm only halfway done that. My desk is clear as fuck. I only got two parts of the sound wall up because I'm sick of shit. I don't know if you can hear, but I've been sick of shit for like a week or so now, and it seems like every single time I get better, depressing drama shit happens, which fucks with my chi, and then I get sick again, and that just seems to be repeating ever since like October, I think, probably more like September. But this is just over and over and over and over. But this time it's because winter's coming and temperature change. Yada 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 yada. God, I'm rambling stupidly. This is gonna be a lot longer video than I planned. So if you're still listening to this and watching this, thanks, Trooper. You deserve a star. If I had a star, I'd give it to you. But hey God, this was like only the first thing I wanted to talk about. I still got other things to talk about, but okay. So I painted a vague picture, you know. And despite me being sick and me not doing much shit on YouTube, also I said this last year, usually what I've learned works for me is the more I plan to take a hiatus from YouTube, the more I'll stream. So that's what I've been doing. I've been streaming a lot again lately, and that's what usually happens. Either I chill on YouTube for a while, and then I go to Twitch, and then I come back and forth. That seems to be what I end up doing a lot. And I'm just letting you know that's still a thing. It still exists. Because of that, not to mention, like I was saying earlier, I don't have a whole lot to show the rest of the world when I say, hey, I've been working on this YouTube thing for years. I like to spend a lot of time into it, but when, you know, they ask me to show something for it, I don't have a lot that the rest of the world is proud of or okay with. I get the, oh, okay. It's like, oh yeah, I make YouTube videos. Oh, how much you make from that? I don't really make anything. Oh, okay. You're one of those people. Like, that's the vibe the whole conversation goes. But, you know, this, like I said, it doesn't affect, the only reason why it affects me is because it affects the rest of the world, which affects me. This is encouraging me at the same time to try to step it up. Like, I've realized one of my worst things is self-advertising. I'm horrible at promoting myself. Like, when I would see other channels explode, I would be like, hey, you know, I knew you, you know, before your channel existed, but what the hell would you do? And it would be a lot of, you know, oh, I just posted on forums, I just spammed Twitter, I just did all these advertisement posting things, and they work. I can't say they don't. Me personally, I feel very, very scummy when I do that, so I have a really hard time advertising myself. So, but I've also learned I gotta try to step it up. I want this channel to be bigger. I want it to grow. I want it to be something I can be more proud of when I tell people about it. I want this to be something that maybe the world could remember me as if you know, I grow old and don't do anything else great with my life. You know, I want this to be important and bigger than it has been. And I don't think I'm in the wrong in wanting that. This is kind of my baby I've been creating and trying to nurture. And maybe I haven't been nurturing it well. And I'm starting to worry. And I feel like I'm okay with worrying and wanting more out of it. Because I don't know, it doesn't feel like a wrong thing to say. It feels like a correct mentality. I want something more out of what I want to put my time and effort into. I want it to be more. And so I've been looking around, and one of the biggest problems that I have had and had been told was the whole names thing. I go by a bunch of different names. Carms, Karzie. You guys know me as Karzie. Other people know me as Carms. But don't get me wrong, everyone like that meets me from the past few years has been calling me Karzie, real life and online. So Karzie is the main go-to name for me. But I've had a bunch of other names before. And not to say that's the huge issue, but because I couldn't get Karzie when I was, you know, starting up YouTube and starting up Twitch and everything, I had to go by different names. And at the time, I was okay with the name Placebo Manifestation. It was catchy, I liked it. It was, if you really thought about it, it meant a lot of different cool things, but you know, I liked the value of that. That was great for what I wanted to do back then. I wanted to do a lot more animating. I wanted to do a lot more video creating. I wanted to do a lot, well, not video creating, but, well, yes, video creating, but I wanted to do not like gameplays. I wanted to do like animating, machinima, artsy stuff. I wanted to do something that takes a lot of time and effort and make something really cool. And then the Placebo Manifestation name and label fits because it's a label for something like that. Since then, I've changed a bit, and I wanted to do, you know, gameplay commentary and just have stupid fun. And a name like Placebo Manifestation is too wordy. I don't even tell people, go to, what's your channel? Go to youtube.com/placebomanifestation. No one's gonna remember that. Like, that, I mean, okay, maybe it's just me, but the internet is not capable of holding that many syllables in their head, being able to spell it right, or having anywhere near enough energy to, or not energy, but enough fucks to put in an effort to even try to find that. And I can't say I blame them. Placebo Manifestation, it's wordy. It's not exactly pleasing. So what I've been telling people over the past year or so is just look up Karzie and you'll find it, because that's a lot easier. I just say, just go to YouTube, search Karzie, because that's what people will remember. That's what people will do. And so that's worked. Now, when I went to Twitch, and I'm even streaming on another site now. There's, was it Beam Pro? If You're really anti-Twitch. I stream to both at the same time, so you go Twitch/Pixelphiliac or BreamPro/Pixelphiliac and you'll find me. This is all leading up to something. I'm just horrible at actually, you know, properly doing a, you know, fluid mental movement of connecting the pieces. What I'm trying to say is I have to come together under a name. I have to come together under something that is easier to remember, easier to say, something I'm a little more proud of and not as awkward to try to, you know, say and express to people. So, God, on that note, so I've changed everything to Pixelphiliac. I am still very much Karzie. I will still always go by Karzie, but you may have noticed that in YouTube, my name has changed to Pixel Space Philiac. The reasoning for that is so now people can find my channel by going to youtube.com/pixelphiliac, which is, you know, the name I go across multiple other platforms, which I'll get into in a minute. But, you know, to me, Pixelphiliac's a lot more internet good. It's something that makes me smile in my corner every time. Pixelphiliac, it's something that I'm much more comfortable with, even though I probably shouldn't be as much to the outside world. This is, you know, if you say, oh, Placebo Manifestation, oh yeah, it's company label name Pixelphiliac, what the fuck, like, outside world people don't always view it the same way. But either way, in one of my attempts to basically get my name out there and try to make this bigger is social media. I got told social media is like a must, and I have always hated social media. I'm really horrible at upkeeping it. Facebook is just a breeding ground of drama. I don't like it. So I've kept social media very much at an arm's length. Now with Twitter, I've been trying to get into it because I feel like if I'm going to get into anything, it's going to be Twitter, because it seems more my style. But I understand that to help get my name out there, I gotta do more social media stuff. So and this is part in helps of a friend. I've kind of expressed that I want something more out of this. I want to feel like, you know, when I put effort and work into it, it's going to be something that I can be mixture of proud of, something that's actually gonna come back to me, something that my friends aren't just going to refer to as I'm just a shitty joke at this point, you know, on YouTube. I want something more out of it. And so I've asked other people around, and one of my friends, she's gonna help me set up my social media stuff, and she helped me in deciding that I needed to put it all under one name. And since Twitch was already Pixelphiliac, I thought that was a great name. I had to register under other sites as Pixelphiliac, a mixture as a backup and for future ideas, and just like I think I registered on Dailymotion on Pixelphiliac the day that YouTube Heroes came out, because I you know, everyone was fearful of that, and I probably for good reason, because that would just kind of annihilate any form of content I have, or any form of fame I could get from it, I guess. And I don't feel like Google's changing anytime soon, so, you know, to get my name around and to have multiple backups, I've had to choose another title to go as, and I didn't want Placebo Manifestation, so I chose the Pixelphiliac. So now, I can be found on youtube.com/pixelphiliac, twitch.tv/pixelphiliac, beanpro/pixelphiliac, twitter.com/pixelphiliac, facebook.com/pixelphiliac, and I don't even know what the Google Plus one is, to be honest. It's whatever is linked to this account. And I want it to stay that way. It's gonna basically be trying to be Pixelphiliac across the board so people can find me and I'm not known under these different names, which is bad for internet personalities, and to be honest. So yes, there's that. So Pixelphiliacs across the board. If you want to follow, sub, do whatever they do, I'd appreciate that. But pick your poison. Which content/social media do you want? There you go. It's all there. And I've been trying to keep up on posting on them. It should post every single time a video comes up, I'd imagine. And I've been trying to, you know, tweet, post, whatever. Whenever I stream, I've been bad on it the past 2 days, but either way, I've been trying to get better at it. That's what I'm trying to say. Now the name Pixelphiliac, on YouTube, I don't plan that to stay. I plan to still change it to make it like Karzie Pixelphiliac or something like that. The OCD of the space is fucking with me. I don't like that. And I'm pretty sure it's fucking with a lot of other people too, so. But I can't change that until a few months from now. It's just, in order to get the URL that I wanted, the youtube.com/pixelphiliac, I had to change my name. And I changed my name a few times to try to get it right. And now I got it right, but now I can't change my name again until like 3 to 6 months, so. Hopefully in 3 to 6 months, that'll be fixed. Wow, this is a lot longer than I thought it would be, by leaps and fucking bounds. I apologize. There's probably someone out there going like, you could have explained this in like 5 minutes. But I wanted to ramble. I wanted to connect. I wanted to show you guys a bit of insight of what a Karzie is, where the chi fuckery is, when I say things fucked up my chi, or, you know, why I want this channel to grow, the steps I have to take to try to get there, which is donning this Pixelphiliac title across the board. And hopefully, you know, so you guys know that I still want this to be a thing. And this isn't one of those empty, oh, I want it to be a thing, but I'm going to do nothing. I know too many people like that, and it's pissing me off at this point. So I don't want it to be that either. I want you guys to know that I'm still around, still want this to be a thing. But I'm still me, nonetheless. I mean, I'm still a human being that gets fucked with, the chi fucks up, the mental states. I still have urges, I still have wants, and I still gotta live in the same world, run my money and everything else, culture, you know, so, yeah, I guess I just wanted to, express that, and probably a lot longer than I planned, so I apologize if the time, length is a problem, but I tend to do a lot of things on long drawn out explanations anyways. This is just something I've always done. It's just a Karzie thing, I guess. So anyways, I hope you guys are doing fine. I know Christmas is a stressful time for a lot of people, and I'm sure I'm not the only one going through hard times. But I hope you guys are doing well. I honestly mean that. If you wanna see what I've been up to or see content from me, I'll be on Twitch or Beam Pro. Preferably Twitch, that's the place that everyone goes to, but if you're, like, super anti-Twitch for some reason, then that's there for you, too. The Beam Pro is... I have a chat program to try to monitor both. It's a little off, so... There's also no notifications appearing on stream when people follow on Beam Pro. It's only Twitch, so... I'm just letting you guys know these are things that are happening. But I'll be there. I'll be trying to stream as much as I can because it helps me feel productive and I like that. And I can even do it when I'm sick, which seems to be a lot during this time. So hopefully I'll see you guys there. Feel free to drop by and say hi. Hopefully I won't be AFK because it seems like everyone joins my stream when I decide to go for, like, a cigarette and then I have to get dragged in the store or some shit. Like, there's some crazy shit that happens in those AFK breaks. Like, I never intended. It's like, oh, okay, I'll put on the AFK screen so I can, make a sandwich. I'm gonna make a sandwich. I go into the kitchen, car fucking plows through the wall. There's always something. And then I come back and it's like, oh, I've been AFK for like half an hour. Holy fuck, I feel bad. And that's like, chat would be dead. Like, nothing since the start of stream. Then I'll go have a cigarette for like 10 minutes. Come back, there's three people going, oh my god, what the fuck? And they're gone. Like, it's... What the fuck? What the fuck, internet? Why does internet like it when I do nothing? I get more subs when I don't upload things. Oh, which reminds me, I got told there were YouTube changes, and they punish small channels from what I hear. I'm told that small channels even lose subs for uploading now. I don't know how true this is. This seems a bit far-fetched. I mean, I won't know until I actually record and edit another series, which I don't really plan to do anytime super soon because... holidays and shit. Like I say, I'm gonna be streaming, so please feel free to drop by and watch me stream shit. The streaming shit I've been doing lately, a lot of Heroes of the Storm, a lot of Hearthstone, a lot of Robocraft, what else? It's a lot of that, but there are other games too, and I'm definitely open to suggestions. It's just no one ever suggests anything, so it's like, okay. Or when people suggest, it's always like some horrible, horrible, like shitty Flash game from like 2 decades ago or something. Like, it's always something weird. It's like, oh god, I don't know what to play.
You should play the Japanese PlayStation 1 Hello Kitty.
What? Like, it's always this crazy shit out of nowhere. Or this incredibly shitty looking horrible game or something. Like, it's... yeah, it's rarely ever a good idea, I'll be honest. I apologize, but this is just what's happened. But yeah. Hopefully the YouTube changes aren't that big of a deal, or they'll be fixed by the time I come back. If they are a deal, then I'll admit I am gonna have to do something, but I don't know what that is. It may be uploading on multiple sites. It may be just going streaming. I don't know. I don't know yet. It's one of those things I just kind of have to, you know, see what happens. But yeah, I think I've talked about everything. I think you've gotten a bit of Karzie dose and understand a little bit what's going on, I hope. So I gotta blow my nose. Hold on. Oh, apologize if that was, I don't know what that sounded like. Like, I faced away, like, kind of put my head in the chair a little. But anyway, hopefully I wasn't disgusting or something. I don't really plan to edit this that much. It's going to be a lot of raw footage here. But that's fine. So, I hope you guys are doing good. Good luck with classes, finals, dramas, Christmas, whatever shit you got going for you. I wish you the best of luck. Wanna know where I'm at? Stop by twitch.tv/pixelphiliac and I'll be hanging around there for a little while until I come back to YouTube. And I'll try to be keeping up with social media. Is there anything else I want to say? Okay. Alright. Well, again, happy holidays to everyone, and hopefully you're doing fine, and I'll see you later. Alright. Take care, my people. Stay awesome. Karzie out. Okay.